One Punch Man, 10 Pieces of Orochi Fan Art We Love. Orochi is an epic character, both in terms of size and power. The massive One Punch Man anime fan favorite has inspired many talented fan artists. There is no doubt that Orochi has the look of a final boss, be it in an anime or a JRPG. He's got the size and imposing presence you'd want from a bad guy, dwarfing all who come into contact with him. One gets a general sense of epicness from him that isn't always the case with most bad guys in the One Punch Man series. While he doesn't end up being the true final boss, he's still one of the main antagonists of the Human Monster Saga. An arc filled with some great and powerful baddies. What helps prop Orochi up and make him a prime candidate for fan art are the multiple forms that he has, in addition to his aforementioned massive size. 10. Living Nightmare. Everything about this image by Golden Smuff screams, nightmare. The rows upon rows of pink teeth look like they could shred you up in no time, using your bones as nothing more than toothpicks. The fact that his skin is cracking and decaying shows just how monstrous he is in power and appearance. Most unnerving of all may be those eyes, though. It isn't just that they are glowing like balls of energy. It's how dark and hollow the sockets are. 9. Monster King. The black and white coloring by Golden Smuff makes Orochi a little more palatable and less frightening than the first image. While some of the fear factor has died down, this piece gives a greater view of the Monster King, showing off his enormous visage. He's got the mass of a creature like Godzilla, with his body looking even more horrific. The best part may be the detail in his heart, with its intricately woven veins. 8. Metamorphosis. The coolest part about Orochi may be how often he shifts his shape, taking on a more dragon-like form here. The sheer amount of dragon heads and mouths he has is both ridiculous and incredible all at the same time. His head alone looks like it's about 5 different mouths layered on top of each other. Killer Evo does a great job on representing scale as well. Orochi looks the size of a skyscraper in comparison to his opponent. It gives one a great sense of why he's so intimidating. 7. Torn Apart. It's cliche, and purposely so considering it's One Punch Man, but these are the types of epic-looking fights you want an arc or even series to end on, one lone hero leaping into combat with a villain who looks unbeatable. It's a classic trope for a reason, and that's because it works. Infinity Gohan captures the direness of the moment well, dragons all snapping and clawing at the hero, trying to get him before he can land a punch. Orochi's face rising out of the flames only further solidifies the grim nature of the situation. 6. Consume You. Orochi vs. Garou was a fascinating fight, one that got to show off just how powerful the former is as a foe. It was an interesting way to go about it as well, since you don't get villain versus villain battles all that often in anime. As with much of his fan art, Nijin-sama does a good job with the scaling of Orochi, his head alone about 10 to 20 times larger than Garou. Having Orochi pulling his form out of what seems like a cloud really drives home what a monster he is, too. 5. One Punch. The flames by Beck 45 keep Orochi looking like a monster, only one that's a little more demonic rather than a giant dragon. He looks more like an ancient deity that's just been summoned from the depths of hell. Saitama, the only one that stands in his way from ravaging the world. That confident stance he has shows he has no fear of Orochi's power, and why should he? He's the strongest human around. Only needing that one punch. 4. True Dragon. This form makes Orochi look more like a dragon than any other he takes in the series, appearing as a massive hydra-like creature, not unlike King Ghidorah from Godzilla fame. The closeness of the image lets you get a great look at just how many layers of mouths Orochi has near where his face once was. It puts the xenomorphs to shame with how many there are. Evan 36 draws shows great detail with each of them, all fantastically drawn. 3. Demon God. Orochi looks like he belongs more in Demon Slayer here than One Punch Man, as he seems like he came straight out of a pit of hellfire. Evan 36 draws makes him look like a gross mutation between human and dragon. Mirroring the two sides of him beautifully. You could see something like this being the final boss of just about any RPG. He'd probably be a 3 or 4 phase fight as well. Hitting you with a wide variety of attacks. 2. Master. You'd never want to disappoint a boss like Orochi, as he's more than just an intimidating presence. He has a low tolerance for failure, going so far as consuming you as punishment for messing up. Knight 133 recreates an image from the manga itself, capturing much of the fear an underling would have when talking to his master. The artist makes his skin very similar to that of Nemesis from Resident Evil. Very muscular and cobbled together. 1. Mutation. Orochi's form here makes him look like a complete mutation, a creature someone made in a lab by splicing a bunch of creatures' DNA together to see what would happen. He's got a mix of dragon heads and scales, coupled with a hardened skeletal mass. His face is a macabre mix of horns and stretched skin. Furchizaki makes him look more disgusting than truly horrific. A being that's coming apart at the seams and can't truly maintain what he is any longer.